Hi guys, welcome back to our drone channel. To not be surprised, I'm on the way in my car right now, okay? Recently, DJI has released the Mini 4 Pro drone. Today I brought to you 5 things you may not know about this new drone, and I know that you are curious, so stay tuned! If you like what you see, then help the channel to grow and subscribe. With the new Mini 4 Pro drone, the time of drone overheating are counted when doing, for example, a firmware update. And I'll show you right now why.
Nearly every Mini 3 Pro user was a bit afraid of firmware updating the drone because those updates could take a lot of time. Waiting 10 to 20 minutes may well be possible. As the Mini 3 Pro did not have any cooling fans, it got hotter and hotter until it sometimes shut automatically off, failing the update. DJI implemented a new mode which is shown on the backside LEDs of the Mini 4 Pro. If the two LEDs in the middle light up, so-called eco mode is active. This mode shuts down the drone system to the maximum so that overheating no longer occurs. And it is automatically enabled when updating the firmware.
Isn't that a cool feature? I know lots of you are interested if the Mini 3 batteries are also fitting into the Mini 4 Pro. The answer is yes, but...
Alright, what is the issue? Let's have a look at the batteries of the Mini 4 Pro. As we can see, they have a capacity of 2590 mAh hours and a voltage of 7.32 VDC, putting it on a scale which shows us exactly 76 grams. And here comes the comparison with the Mini 3 Pro battery. It has a capacity of 2453 mAh hours at a voltage of 7.38 VDC. But what does the scale say? It shows 79 grams, which is a difference of 3 grams plus minus. This could have an effect on our ultralight drone. If it would raise the weight above 249 grams, the Mini 4 Pro would fall into different and more strict regulations. Therefore, let's check it inside the drone. First of all, I insert the regular battery. As we can see, the scale shows 248 grams. That is according to the EU regulations of C0 labeled drones. Let me insert the battery of the Mini 3 Pro with a higher weight and put it on the scale as well. Alright. Now you can see the problem with your own eyes. The weight of the drone is above 250 grams. Therefore, DJI immediately shows a message in the Fly app as soon as you use a Mini 3 Pro battery, indicating to you that the aircraft is no longer compliant with the regulations.
Alright, so be careful if you're using your previous Mini 3 Pro batteries, okay? Okay, coming to another pretty interesting topic. What about the lens?
Well, we know from the Mini 3 and Pro version that the cover in front of the lens can be detached by a slight rotation. Afterwards, it is possible to attach, for instance, a wide lens or any kind of fitting ND filter. The Mini 4 Pro does keep this easy function and the way how to do it. But do the accessories from the precursor also fit here? Let's try the wide angle lens. The flanges don't seem to fit in the small holes, so I can't attach it. Alright, check it for the original ND filters from DJI. Doesn't fit either, which was for sure to be expected. So same issue. Okay, here I have some new filters from Farewell for the Mini 4 Pro. Let's attach them, which should work fine as they should have the correct mounting points for the flanges. Looking good. Here we see both lens covers, upper one Mini 3 Pro, lower one Mini 4 Pro. They are slightly different and both cams without covers. You can see the diameter are varying and the flanges do have different dimensions, which is the reason for the non-fit of the lens and filters.
Yeah, I know, that is a pity and I'm also pretty not happy about it, but it is what it is. Coming to a more positive bullet point, which is called USB connection for file transfer.
Alright, DJI has overworked the USB-C port on the tail of the drone. With the Mini 4 Pro, you can just connect and start and there is no necessity in switching the drone on. Keep it packed, connected, and start working immediately. When using a Windows operating system, a new Explorer window will be opened, showing you the root of your drone. Your footage is stored by default in the folder DCIM and then DJI-001. In another tutorial, I'm gonna show you how you can change this default settings. Anyway, here we have all our pictures and videos. By double-clicking of one of the images, it is instantly shown. Also, the process of copying and pasting works as usual, nothing special. But the process of connecting the drone has pretty much improved.
Ain't that cool? I'm pretty sure most of you are aware of the new auxiliary light on the bottom of the Mini 4 Pro. But do you also know about that?
Well, the auxiliary light can be activated or deactivated manually. Therefore, we find a setting in the menu tab Safety called Auxiliary LED. We can choose between auto, on and off. The latter two should be clear to everyone. Auto whereas does mean that the drone automatically switches the light on and off depending on the height and lighting conditions. However, what you choose, you always get a short feedback on the display. As it is awkward to always open the menu in order to change the setting, you also can assign this function to a button of the RC2 remote. Therefore, we find a setting in the menu tab Control, scrolling a bit down to Button Customization. In this submenu, it is possible to now assign it to a button. For example, the C1 button, which is the left one on the back side. Just choose Auxiliary Light. And from now on, by pushing the button, we are switching between the three possible options. That is pretty handy and could also be hardly helpful finding your drone in the night sky. By the way, the word auxiliary is incredibly tongue-breaking and hard to pronounce for German. So hope these 5 things were quite helpful for you. If you liked the video, smash the like button, drop me a comment below and sub to the channel. Thanks for watching, see you, bye bye.